Cincinnati is real. And their cultural defense is real. They expect to play really, really well. And, you know, so that's going to be fun. It's going to be a regular challenge for our guys. One they'll be excited about.
How about offensive line? City of Burns out. Some of you guys put King Green in there. Youngster, big old boy playing guard. What do you think about that group?
Well, again, Caden's done fantastic. He literally can play any of the positions up front. He would do a nice job. You only get so many reps that you can take in practice. And so we've made a lot of his time has actually been outside through camp and whatnot. And he did a great job there. This really allows him to play in a really aggressive spot, you know, at this age. And gives us a great option inside. He's a big body guy that, you know, was tough, he's physical, he's got really good fundamentals, super smart, can play fast, his endurance is incredible. Huge ball take gets to that third level, and that does a really nice job there. Again, he does a nice little jump. Again, he hadn't practiced a whole lot live for a long time, and so this was kind of the focus for this game, to get those guys going again. And we know that Marcus and Paul Lee are two veterans that you can really count on. And the real focus was just trying to get those other guys going. And because you don't always get those opportunities to develop everybody. You know, you go with a hot hand sometimes, and then sometimes you want to force feed some things when you feel like you have the opportunity to. Because we got to continue to develop, you know, the depth there.
Tell us how Coach Ricardo Williams there in the second quarter, the more mobile quarterback. They put a couple of the drives together, Vanya. Is that, you know, I don't even know what the point. Is it though a little bit of a blessing because you're going to see Emory Jones this week that you get some tape of what it's like to try to defend a mobile quarterback?
Yeah, no doubt. You can't simulate that to that degree in practice. And you know, I was not real. I thought we relaxed a little bit. You know, I thought things got really easy. That could be a sign of immaturity in that moment, which I think we had, and not the same sense of urgency and the edge and the desperation and the focus that it takes, being precise and detail. And just we got a little casual at times in those two drives, like they were just going to fall down for us. And we've said it a long time, it doesn't matter who you're playing against, if you're not doing all the little things well. Not the gap, if you don't have the right alignment, if you don't have the right eyes, if you don't have the right entry angle, if you don't have the right pad level, you know, this game will expose you. The flip side, it will honor you when you're doing all those little things right, too. And you can be a stud of a player just doing little things right, being smart, being technically sound, and being lined up right, being in the right alignments and the right trusting your keys, what it's going to be doing, you have to be a great athlete. Player. So that's a challenge. But our guys are super humble. They don't like that either. That's our fuels a little bit. But after maybe the initial drive in the second half, I thought we responded pretty good after that. So, like I said, there's a lot to teach from, and that's a great thing. And, you know, really good, strong win that you have a lot that you know you can correct.
I'm going to take a quick break. We'll hit some of your questions for Coach.